Hi, my name's Becky Pell. I'm a monitor engineer with over 25 years experience in live music and touring, with artists including Kylie Minogue, Aha, Muse, Take That, Anastasia, Westlife, and the War of the Worlds. I started mixing monitors around the time when in-ear monitoring was beginning to gain traction as an alternative to wedges. Soon afterwards, digital desks began to arrive on the market, and so I was involved in those transitions in the way we mix. When I first tried KLANG in 2018, I immediately felt that this was the next big transition, the next game changer in monitor mixing. I loved how natural and spacious the mixes felt, how intuitive the interface operation was, and I was really impressed with the fact that mixing in this binaural, immersive 3D environment, which is, after all, how humans hear, meant that I could reduce overall mix levels by around 3 dB, and the central element of the mix, like a drummer's click or a singer's vocal, by as much as 6 dB. That's huge when it comes to protecting our hearing, and that alone was reason enough to get on board with KLANG. And the fact that the quality of listening experience that it allowed me to deliver to artists and musicians was so beautiful and open meant that there was no question in my mind that KLANG was the way forward. These were the discoveries I made when I first demoed the KLANG Fabric unit during the summer of 2018 on tour with Anastasia. When I was asked later that year to mix monitors on Jeff Wayne's epic live production of his orchestral prog rock extravaganza, The War of the Worlds, I knew that KLANG was going to help me to recreate his amazing album in a live setting, and it did. Jeff was delighted with the KLANG mix. The listening experience was fantastic. There were certain limitations for Fabric with such a complex production. For example, my inputs number well into the hundreds, so I had to choose which of them to put into the 56 inputs of the KLANG domain. And if I wanted to use more KLANG mixes, I needed to reduce the number of inputs to free up processing power. KLANG was also an external entity rather than fully integrated into my workflow. With the introduction of the KLANG DMI cards with new generation FPGA processing and Digico console integration, a lot of that was solved. 16 mixes could enjoy the full 64 inputs, and my mixing workflow was seamless, with all of the KLANG facilities now on my Digico console. That's absolutely perfect for the band I've worked with for many years, Westlife, who I'm using KLANG with on their upcoming tour. Still, with a big complex production like The War of the Worlds and many others these days, my input list goes well beyond 64. Wouldn't it be cool to have, well, more?
More's more. What do you want?
To get back on the road. I want to go on tour. Two tours at the same time, if possible.
Okay. Well, I think I will just form a band with Austin and James, and maybe we can hire you.
Let's do it.
But in the meantime, you said you want more. I assume you're talking about input numbers, right?
Yeah.
How much will we have for?
It'd be good if we could double it, if we could go 128.
Okay. Tall order, but we can do that. I assume you're going to be fine with four mixes or so?
No, I have more people than that on stage.
Eight?
I have a lot of people on stage. Could we double that and go 16?
Okay, all right. Well, but it's a whole lot of inputs and outputs, so how are we getting that into that box? Dante, Mahdi, or rather OptoCore?
I'd like to be really flexible with it. I'd like to have all of them.
How about we do that with DMI cards?
Yeah, that's perfect.
So we can exchange them and it's future-proof.
Perfect.
To whatever might come.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Anything else?
It would be cool to have EQ capability on the KLANG inputs. I wouldn't use that for every production, but I can see some instances where it would be handy.
Okay, so something like the root intensity EQs that we have on our other processors.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, got it. Okay, anything else?
Really good queuing, like a really good quality headphone amp.
Okay, so a studio grade headphone amp directly integrated into a unit,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And how would I queue into that?
I guess the easiest way would be a touchscreen, because that would be super flexible.
Yeah, that's how we work now, right?
Okay, let's throw in a touchscreen.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay, so let's take a look at what our R&D team came up with in the past year. We'll be right back. So, what do you think?
That's fantastic. I can't wait to use it. How big is it?
It's 3 rec units.
Okay. And so that, if you've got it on optical, that just sits in your optical loop with your front of house desk and broadcast, say, or whoever else?
Correct. Correct. Okay, like fantastic. Every other device, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And a DMI card carries 64 inputs. So mm-hmm. how do we get 128 in?
You just use 2 DMI cards. For example, 2 optical cards.
Because we've got the 3 slots.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah. So you have enough options for that. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. If I run at 96K, do I lose any inputs?
Absolutely not. No.
Brilliant.
The unit doesn't even care about that.
Okay. So I can send loads of inputs in. Can I convert between cards, say for a virtual sound check?
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's actually where the third slot comes into play. So you can just convert that to Dante, for example, and use the Dante virtual sound card to record something, play it back, or even for the controller.
Okay. And is it compatible with the controller?
Oh
then?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay. Because I can see that being really useful if you've got a really big production like War of the Worlds, mm-hmm. or I've got band and singers and an orchestra. That's a lot of people to keep my eyes on. So to have the orchestra on the controllers and that all integrated, that works really well.
Oh yeah. And especially since the controller can just pick and choose 24 channels, stereo channels actually, out of those 128 channels mm-hmm. that the conductor is giving us.
Yeah.
So you can just run a combination of a couple of submixes to the orchestra musicians, and they just route their own instrument also into an individual channel there. So
fantastic.
Full flexibility for everyone, yeah.
Brilliant. And the latency on the Fabrique is really low. What's the latency on this?
It's actually even lower. You could say it's about a tenth of that.
Oh, wow.
So it's a quarter millisecond.
Fantastic. Well, I can't wait to use it out on the road.